Hey, my name is Garrett, and I'm working on Strung By Three, a martial arts stealth combat game. This week, I finally made those 3D colorful space clouds, which are nebulas. They shift around, have some transparency, and change colors depending on how I set the parameters with Shader Graph. I'm still gonna iterate on it and add some like secondary noise to make it look a little bit less uniform and mess around with the different color shading options, but I'm really liking how it's looking so far. For the player combat, I used a placeholder model to change colors and signal if you're using a block, strike, or kick. And I sort of had this functionality in the menu beforehand, but now it's in a keys press and it's a little bit different. I also tried changing the ring I had for the player noise that I did last week and changing that to a shader. I'm still having trouble with that, doing it in like 2D and 3D space, but it's not too important right now. And I've been working more with the displace shaders, working again with the rocks, adding some static and moving displacement. So technically, if I have different instances of the same material, I can make each rock model look different, even though they come from the same base model. I've still been figuring out some different modifier combinations in Blender to generate some cooler looking environments, and I'll probably just end up using that and some more tweaks inside of Unity itself. What I learned this week is a lot about material instancing. If I wanted to make the rocks look different by using the same material, I have to make different instances of them or else they'll end up just looking the same. Now I kind of did this through what's called material property blocks, and so I can set the parameters in code I want to change or randomize, like for example, the colors and the static displacement, and the ones that I don't change in code, like the moving displacement, will still affect both. So they end up looking different, but if I change the moving displacement, it changes between the two. I'm a little still kind of lost with it. Like, I feel like I don't fully understand it yet, and it works, but it's not an instance like I've seen it before where it's actually like a different material. So I'm not sure if I'm completely doing it right, but I'm at least along the right track because it does get the desired effect I want. And I learned a lot about working with, well, I mean, Shader Graph, which specifically about the clouds and nebulas. I really enjoyed working with it a lot. I followed along, like I talked about last week, with that base cloud tutorial, and I just kind of modified stuff until I kind of got this desired look and feel for what I wanted the nebulas to look like. I managed to get this 3D looking ring effect around the island by actually raising the outer edge of the 2D sort of hexagonal shape that the tutorial had me make in Blender, and it gave it this effect where it looked raised and it looked like the clouds were more up around you. And it turns out that displacing almost 400,000 vertices tends to eat up a lot of FPS, so I made a lower poly version with like 50,000 verts, and it obviously looks better for how I have it set up in Shader Graph. So I'm gonna need to experiment with different sizes and vertice counts, but the desired effect is still there now. And in my martial arts training, I worked a little bit with B-twists more this week, and I kind of stopped because my back was kind of hurting me throughout this week, a little sore. I still ended up doing a lot of strength training and a lot of kicks, so I'm hoping by next week we'll be back at it. And what I've been thinking about a lot is the game's core. Now, I know that the game is going to have martial arts, stealth, and combat, like I said at the beginning, but I'm not exactly sure how. Like, I know I like all those things, and I'm inspired a lot by Assassin's Creed, but I feel like I have several different ideas of how I could do each and combine them, and I feel like I'm just kind of lost in terms of picking one. Like, I feel like one week I have this idea, the next I have this idea, and I'm just not exactly sure. That's why I've kind of been shying away from doing more gameplay intensive stuff and focusing more on the art, because I'm really not sure yet. Even though I did a ton of planning beforehand, I feel like still stuff is changing. So I've kind of been just trying to figure out what's the core, like what's the main things I want, and trying to build an idea around that. I still have to kind of pull all different ideas I have together and figure out what that really is. So I'm gonna try to figure that out as soon as possible, because I want, you know, some sort of playable version soon, at least even just for me personally, so I can feel like I'm moving forward in the right direction instead of kind of just aimlessly wandering around kind of like how I am now. Alright, that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love every single one of you. If you need anything at all, please feel free to talk to me. Like, I'm more than happy to talk with you guys on Discord. I know a few guys have reached out, and I really appreciate talking with you guys. So anytime, it's not a bother at all. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next devlog for some more fun.